this other field. I'm sitting in the opening here between the two fields. They came in probably 40 yards away. If you couldn't tell already, it's a little wet today. It's been raining on and off all day, and it's pouring rain right now. Thankfully, I haven't left the truck yet, so I'm just gonna hang out here until it this blows over. I don't think it'll last too long, so. Okay, guys, change of plans here. Looks like there's some more weather coming. It was supposed to be clear for the rest of the day, but that is not the case. Looks like there's a couple more showers coming through. So I don't really have any interest in sitting in a tree stand and getting pouring rain on. So I'm just gonna ground hunt tonight. Just walk back in there, see what sign I can find. So I'm just bringing the GoPro. Unfortunately, I only have one battery, so it's gonna be pretty limited tonight for footage, but I'm gonna have to use it sparingly. I'm gonna walk back in there, see what I can find. Like I said, last year I was in here, saw a ton of rubs. It's a super thick area. There's some open area right next to it, so I'm hoping that they're going to be moving along the edge. But who knows? I'm just hoping to find some signs set up on later in the year, so we'll see what we can find. Changes things. So I'm just gonna keep following some trails here just to see what's going on in the thicker stuff. Start checking out other oak trees. Maybe some of these other ones are dropping acorns. I don't know. Not looking good so far, though. I just bumped another deer. Almost positive it was a buck. I could hear branches on antlers. That's what it sounded like. But he took off running. Pretty sure he smelled me. I don't know if he could hear me because it's windy and it's raining right now, but I'm pretty sure that was a buck. It's so thick in here you can't see anything. I'm gonna mark this spot on Onyx. Maybe I keep moving. Deer in there, but I'm not gonna come back after for a while after tromping around through there. But I'm gonna head over to the other side of this piece. There's a cornfield, or well, usually there's a field back there of some sort. I don't know what it is this year, but I'm gonna go take a look over there quick. Just kind of maximize my time on the ground here at this spot. So I head over and see what's over there. So I'm actually having to use my phone to record now. My GoPro's only got like 14% left battery, and I need that for if there's going to be any shooting going on, so. But this spot I'm going into, I was in here last year. I think it was my second hunt last year. And had a doe come through at like 20 yards with a couple of fawns. I passed them up. I think tonight I might actually let one rip if a doe comes by, but we'll see what happens. This other field is beans. It was all corn last year, so we'll see what kind of crop they got in there this year. But, if it's beans, I should be able to see anything coming out in that field, even from the ground. I'll just get tucked back into some grass or something and wait and see what happens. Got 50 minutes left of hunting light. I think I might just go in there. I want to be on that other field. And if I spook them, I spook them, but I don't think they're very pressured so far this year. They're already out well before 6. It's not dark for another hour. I think I'm just going to push around the edge of the field. Ideally, I'd like to be on the far other side of the other field. I got some trail cam videos a couple years ago. Some nice bucks that were going through back in there. I don't know. I don't know what's back in there right now, so October is not exactly our ideal time to be scouting on the ground, but I'm very limited on time, so like most people, I've got a full-time job. I can only hunt on my weekends, so yeah, I think I'm just gonna go for it. See what happens. Thank you. two small bucks that just walked out in the field here. I crawled all the way across this other field. I'm sitting in the opening here between the two fields. They came in probably 40 yards away. Guys, that's gonna be it for today. Maybe hunting again next week, and I think I might come in here early. Maybe look around a little bit, see what's going on in here. Or maybe I'll just set up in this corner again, in a tree or something. But got really close there. I definitely would have shot that buck, and I would not have been ashamed of it. I have yet to shoot a deer with my bow, and I didn't get a deer last year, gun or bow season, so I would have been happy to shoot that one. But I'm going to try to duck out of here quick without bumping too much. I'm going to peek into the field and see what might be out there and head back home. But great second day here for 2020. We're seeing deer, so that's good. Hopefully we can keep that going. Well, on my way out here, I bumped some deer in the closer field here. There's three fields. This one's closer to the parking lot. There's a couple more. Man, there's so many deer out here, it's crazy. One, two, three, at least five. Somehow my knock got lit. I don't know how that happened. I did not shoot an arrow, I promise. I did want to just say I'm glad that I decided to push in there. I was just gonna sit on the corner there, but nothing would have walked by. You know, sometimes it's hard to say whether you should push or not. You don't want to pressure them too much, but at the same time, if you don't push, you're not gonna see anything. And that's what I'm finding, is my initial reaction is to hold back, and I've been trained to go against that and try to push a little bit more, and I'm seeing more deer, I'm finding more sign, and it's just working out really good. So I'd encourage you guys to try to push a little bit more if you're a little more reserved like I am. You might bump deer, but at least you'll be in them and you'll have a chance at them. So I'm going to head back to the truck here. Thanks for watching, guys. And hopefully the next video we'll get a deer, but I got a week before that happens, so a lot could change. But we'll see what happens, and we'll see you in the next one.